Hey guys, welcome back to Overall Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video to any of you guys having a Jeep Cherokee between year 2014 and year 2020 currently, guys. If you have a 2.4 multi-air engine, guys, we'll explain if your engine light is on and you have a code such as P1524 or P1524, guys. What causes that code in most cases and how to fix it. Now, this one is based on our experience here at the shop and what we usually see, guys, with that code, but it could be multiple things that can actually trigger that code. Before we start, you can see the engine is out of the car. That way we can show you in a little bit better way, guys, where all the sensors are, how the engine works and how to get to things, because being in the vehicle, it's almost impossible. Another thing, we made almost close to 100 videos taking that engine completely apart, showing you how to fix different components and how to, guys, rebuild your engine. So why we do all that? Pretty simple. Our mission at the shop, guys, is only to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. Now, if you guys need to buy any replacement parts, tools, engine oil, that we'll be talking about, all that will be shared in the description of the video below for your convenience, so please check it out, guys. Okay, you can find all the links. Let me show you what we have here. This is, guys, an engine out of a 2016 Jeep Cherokee. It's a 2.4 multi-air engine, super popular engine, 180. Sometimes it's rated at 184 horsepower. So, the scanner that we use usually to scan the system, okay, it's this device right here. It's Maxicom, called Maxicom, guys. I'll put the link in the description of the video below. Cool thing about that scanner, it's not too expensive and it can pay itself off in one time use, so I'll definitely go for it, guys. It works on any car pretty much, not just Jeep, and we used it on multiple cars and you can see it in our videos all the times. Now, things I like about the scanner, it scans all the systems in your car, number one. Number two, you can read codes from every system in your car. Number three, guys, you can actually delete codes from every system and see live data, number four, which makes it extraordinary, guys. Amazing, amazing scanner. So let me show you now, okay, what we have here and what we'll be talking about. So if you come on the back side of your engine, guys, you're going to suspect, okay, you're going to notice that actually on the back side of the engine, under your water pump, so facing the car, that will be towards the serpentine belt. Your serpentine belt will be right here. You have one sensor, guys. This sensor is known as oil pressure switch or oil pressure sensor, guys. Super common sensor. This sensor detects the pressure of the engine oil, okay, and how much pressure you have in your oil system. Why it's so important? Pretty simple. That engine uses variable timing for every cylinder, guys. Okay, you have four variable timing actuators, so the oil pressure is super important, okay, to be in certain specs, guys. Now, if it drops under specific amount, you can severely damage your engine as well, guys. But things that we notice here at the shop, okay, when you get that code. Number one, low engine level or low engine oil level, guys. Make sure that you have enough engine oil, because sometimes, okay, if you're not having enough oil and you're climbing a hill or taking a sharp curve, okay, the oil pump may get dry for a second and that code can be triggered. Very common, guys. Number two, it could be a bad oil pressure sensor, guys. If it's not working correctly, if it's dirty, that could actually trigger that code as well. Number three, guys, it could be old engine oil that's too thin, that's falling apart, the molecules are not they do not have the density that they need to have, so as a result it could be bad engine oil. That's number three, guys. Now, what else it could be? Check the wiring harness going to the sensor. That's number four, guys. Make sure it's plugged all the way in. Make sure the wiring harness is not broken. Sometimes if somebody worked on it, if they forget to put that clip right here to hold the wires to the intake manifold, that oil pressure sensor, okay, wire can rub against the serpentine belt and it can damage the thing. So that's very common, guys. Now, what I've seen actually happen in the shop, that's number five, guys. Somebody put the wrong type of oil. So it takes 0W20, guys. Very important. Okay, check your manual. For different climates, it may require different oil viscosity, but check, guys, the oil grade, oil specs on the oil to make sure that it meets that, and we'll put the link to the oil that we use, and we never had problems with it, guys. And now, another thing, it could be a faulty oil filter. Why I talk about that? Because if the oil filter fails, guys, okay, the oil filter will be on the front side of your engine. This is your oil filter right here. If it's not letting enough pressure go to the engine, if it's plugged up or the valve inside is not working, what will happen? You will not be building enough oil pressure, and as a result, guys, okay, it will feel like your engine is going bad, guys. And all we have to do, just put a new oil filter. So start with an oil change, guys. That's what I always do. Oil change with the correct oil, correct level. Original oil filter. We'll put the link in the description of the video below. That doesn't fix the problem. Check the wiring harness for the oil pressure switch. You can actually test oil pressure switch, but it's not too easy, guys. I'll recommend to replace it. And you hope that's the case, because otherwise it could be something mechanical in your engine and you don't want that to happen, because you have to start taking things apart, guys. So hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching, and see you guys next time.